Dear colleagues, dear guests, dear journalists, it's my pleasure to be here. I'm a member of the European Parliament. She said it. I'm also in this parliament. I'm a member of the official commission EU-Turkey. And how you can understand, it's a very difficult work what we have to do. Especially in this situation. We all know about the terrible situation for media and press freedom in Turkey. The honorable NGO Freedom House already ranks Turkey as not free since 2013. Similar sounds the evaluation of Turkey's press freedom situation from Reporters Without Borders, ranking Turkey between Mexico and Congo. And in the Article 12 of the current report of Kati Piri, a member of our European Parliament, on the annual Turkey report of the EU Commission summarizes the essentials, and on this report the plenary will debate and vote next week in Strasbourg, as you may know. From my point of view, we have all to call the EU Commission to support not only a dialogue with Erdogan's AKP. The EU Commission and the European Parliament have to support especially the opposition. The results on the referendum showed us a deeply divided Turkish society and a great hope, in my mind, of the half of citizens that human rights are universal for women, for Kurds, for politicians from the opposition, for minorities. During the second election in 2015, the independent Turkish press agency BIANET noted a rapid increase of attacks, not only against alternative and especially Kurdish media channels and newspapers, but also against classical audio, visual, and print media. In this time, the European audience was witness of the attack against editorial offices by state organs, like in the case of Cumhuriyet. At the same time, citizens of Turkey experienced day by day the blocking of social network, as also I did during the election observations, or directly after the attack in Ankara on the 10th October in 2015, when I traveled to Diyarbakir. It was the first time of a total curfew of Sur, the old town of this big Kurdish metropolis, you know. Not only was the classical media production attacked, but also the distribution channels and the platforms for alternative and international news. Since 2014, Turkey's government requested the deletion of content on Twitter very often. That was 5 times more than any other country in the world. And in 2015, Turkey increased this rate once again by 150%. In domestic legislation supporting this process dates back longer than the first loss of the absolutely majority for Erdogan's AKP in June 2015, when the HDP certainly reached the 10% threshold. Now we write, of course, the year of 2017, and we know nothing has become better since. The silence of the EU and my German government remains part of the EU-Turkey deal. The few soft voices and critical reports from the parliament have not changed the oppressive situation of Germans. And as a member of European Parliament and home-based in Berlin, which is one, how you know, which is one of the European cities which the, with the largest Turkish and Kurdish communities, I would say the German government, the German society has a special responsibility for an ongoing dialogue with Turkey, especially with the opposition. And a lot of Turkish and Kurdish scientists and journalists are living in Germany. In case they had the chance to go abroad and had not yet taken away their passports or their social existence. Dear participants, last Friday, the editor-in-chief of the news website, journal.com, Turkey, Mustafa Kulili, published an interview in a bigger German newspaper called Frankfurter Rundschau. He had two words for the current situation. Many journalists who are already in jail currently face. These two words are fair and self-censorship. Last April, I was in Ankara to observe the trial against the co-chair of the HDP, Figen Öksekdag. We were a group of international observers from the Left Party, the Social Democrats, women's organizations, and some members of the HDP. There was no official channel or newspaper that reported on this delegation. In the end, to get informed on this one, had to turn to foreign or small alternative press and media channels. This shows once again, this shows one of the main problems in the challenged media landscape of Turkey. Not only are there too few journalists who are able to work in Turkey, further than 30% of the journalists in Turkey are unemployed compared to 10% of the national average unemployed rate. In a completely dividend Turkey, half of the inhabitants have no possibility to inform themselves through alternative media sources. Most of the parts supporting Erdogan live in the rural areas without access to alternative media sources. There is almost only the media coverage left that is close to the government. The division of society is thus doubled. What should and what could be done? A lot of institutions, NGOs, the European Council, and especially the Venice Commission, used to analyze and announce the situation of the public. Other initiatives are care for journalists in exile, as well as the program Journalist in Residence from the European Center for Press and Media Freedom. Such anonymous programs are not exclusively for Turkish and Kurdish journalists and their families, but in recent years, the majority of applications have come from Turkey. Here we know that EU money is spent on gold. But we have to take care for the media landscape and for more public attention on the situation in Turkey too. We have to take care for an information transfer, for the protection of sources and for alternative forms of media production, so that the citizens of Turkey can also reach online channels, or that solidarity projects from colleagues from all over Europe could reach them. Unfortunately, I have to leave this conference. I have to leave Brussels in a few minutes because I have to go to Berlin to meet projects and colleagues. But I will bring them. There are Kurdish projects in Berlin, but I will bring them the information of this conference, and I hope we meet again soon with better prospects. At last, I want to say we must not be passive spectators. We have to play an active part in assisting the defense of European and universal values like media freedom and freedom of speech. I wish the conference to be a big success with practical outputs, and I thank you for the invitation. Thank you very much.